Lemon Street. So that's kind of where the project kind of grew in size. The original estimate from the engineer, Mike Cannon, was that the project would be around $1.5 million. So we put it out to bid first time, and it came back on a low of $2.8 million. So it was strongly suggested we rebid, which we did. So this second bid, we had bid openings in October. The low bid was Lansdowne Earth and Pipe, and their bid was $2.567 million. And so that's kind of where we sit. We had a shortfall of over $1 million. We struggled to try to come up with a way to pay for this. But until Rural Development said you have to submit bid documents. I said, well, we've already had the bid. And that was per South Carolina Rural Infrastructure Authority bid documents. Well, they said, well, you have to do our bid documents now. But we can't do that because we've already bid the project out. So the USDA RD lane was closed. The only other avenue that we had to get this project done was to go back to our esteemed bond attorney and ask him if there's any way we could combine any of the fees from other things that we charge. And he said yes. The Sunday alcohol sales, which is just passed, by the way, and we started collecting in January, could be added to that. And Mr. Ziegler found the state law, which does allow for drainage projects to be combined with that. So that's kind of where we are. I asked Attorney Ziegler to get up with First Triumph Financial, who we worked with previously, and Tyler Trout, if they would put this out to bid with some of the banking folks that they have on their list that they deal with around the Southeast. They found a bank that was interested. And so the last 3 to 4 weeks, we've been working through the different hoops that they've asked us to jump through. And so to get this project completed and not to lose the grant money of $445,000, we're executing this new master stormwater ordinance and the bond, which is with Sterling Financial. And I'm going to have Mr. Ziegler and then Mr. Tyler Trout explain the technicalities of that. And I've given you about as much information as I can, and I'll hand it off to Mr. Ziegler.
Great. Thank you, Mr. Gallin, Madam Mayor, and always a pleasure to be with you. As Mr. Gallin indicated, he contacted me several months ago regarding the stormwater project and shortfall you were experiencing. You'll remember that we did a stormwater bond last year for this project in the amount of $1,350,000. And this is a borrowing that is secured by and payable from that stormwater fee that you imposed. So what you're able to do in terms of this revenue bond or revenue bond like this is constrained by your by the amount you collect under that stormwater fee. Now, that's not to say that oftentimes in these revenue situations, municipalities, counties, whoever's issuing the bond will try to supplement that with some other available source that can legally be used. And so when we first looked at this, had a couple of different potential ways to handle it, but what we decided in talking to Mr. Garland and the financial advisor First Triumph was to try to, first of all, refinance the existing bond, which could be refinanced, to roll it in with a new money component, the money you need to cover that shortfall. If you did all that and you just did it on the basis of that revenue stream from your stormwater fee, it doesn't cover, it's not a one-to-one. So we started looking for other options. One of the things that Garland suggested was the Sunday alcohol sales fee that you receive pursuant to a referendum I think y'all had last year.
Correct.
You get that whenever someone that's remitted you from DOR when Sunday alcohol permits are issued. That statute has a list of things you can pay for out of the fee. One of the things you can fund out of that license fee is drainage projects. So this is a drainage project. So the sort of complexity, and this really isn't relevant for your analysis, but it's good to know, there's no mechanism under state law that allows you to pledge that fee from the Sunday alcohol sale. State law lets you pledge, i.e. irrevocably put toward the payment of stormwater bonds, stormwater fee. But there's no mechanism that says you can issue a bond that's secured by a pledge of the alcohol license fee. But what you can do is create a mechanism that allows that alcohol license fee, subject to appropriation by council every year, to flow into this stormwater system and have that money available in case you need it. So what we wound up doing was redoing your master ordinance. We did a master ordinance last year, but it didn't have any of the wiring, so to speak, that will allow that stormwater, or would allow the license fee, the alcohol license fee to come in. So we did a new master ordinance that has a separate fund in it that's called the appropriations fund. And from time to time, y'all can appropriate monies from any available source, including, if you want to, every year from that alcohol license fee. Put it in that appropriations fund, and that gives an extra pot of money to pay those bonds in case it's needed. So we've got pledge of the stormwater fee. That's hardwired into the document. Have to use that money to pay the bonds. You've also got the option going forward under this new master ordinance to appropriate, as part of your budget process every year, money from that alcohol license fee. And as that comes in, it becomes restricted and has to be used to pay those bonds. So those two together were enough to make this a saleable prospect for a bank. And one of the issues, in order to make this all work, the term of the bond had to be longer than what you had, because the shorter the term, the higher the payments. The more you stretched out, the lower the end of the payments. And y'all were looking at a cash flow situation. So working with First Tryon, Mr. Garland was able to find Sterling National Bank, which made a proposal of a 20-year term on the bond, which is rare for bank place bonds in this day and age. It's rare to go more than 10 years. 15 years is really a long time, but 20 years is almost unheard of. So he did get, based on what was put together with the stormwater fee, the alcohol license fee, Sterling National Bank is willing to do this bond for a term of 20 years. I'll let Mr. Trout talk about the details of the financing and some of that background, but what you'll have procedurally from a legal perspective, you'll have before you this new master ordinance, which will replace your old one, because we're going to be paying off those bonds that you issued under the old one, and then a new series ordinance, which will be the actual financing ordinance for the new bonds. So we'll need two, Mr. Garland, Madam Mayor, we'll need two separate votes for each one of these ordinances when the time comes. Any questions?
The bond, it can be paid over the next 20 years, right?
That's right. For the first 5 years, the bank wants you to not prepay them. So in their documents, they're going to have a no-call prepayment provision. So for the first 5 years, you cannot give them their money back. But after that, you can give them their money back. There is a period of time where they would charge you a 1% penalty, which is what you have in your current documents as well. Banks want to just have some protection that if you're going to prepay them early, they get a little bit of a fee to offset the economic loss of being taken out. But yes, ma'am, you can prepay it.
That 1% is for the entire loan?
It's just on the entire loan. Yes, sir.
What's outstanding
at that point in time? That's right. So right now, when you close, there's $2.4 million approximately that's going to be borrowed, and that pays off your old debt, funds your new project. So $24,000 is the highest that 1% fee could ever be, $20,000 in 5 years or so, something like that. Yes, sir. And so I'll just elaborate quickly. And again, my name is Tyler Trout. Our firm is First Tryon. We're in Charlotte, North Carolina. We help municipalities in North, South Carolina, and Georgia borrow money. We're on your side of the table, where Ben is your legal expert, we're your financial expert. Our job is to get you as many banks competing for your business as possible so you get the best rates, the best terms and provisions. So again, we're not a bank, we're not lending you money. We're gonna help you find the best overall deal. Sterling National Bank, gentleman Mark Cargo in Charlotte, North Carolina, is going to loan you the money. It's a 4.15% interest rate. It's not final just yet. They want to wait until we get to the closing in early May before they lock that rate. And so we're hopeful that it's around 4%, maybe 4.15%, again, for a term of 20 years. I'll elaborate just a moment. The stormwater revenues that you collect every year are about $135,000. The payments on this bond are going to be about $180,000. So of your temporary license fee, which is about $75,000 that you are expected to collect on a yearly basis, $45,000 of it has got to go to pay this debt. So that money is going to be used for this purpose. The rest of it you can use for other purposes, but just know that of that $75,000 you're collecting, about half of it, a little bit more than that, will be used to make the payments on this bond. And the last thing I'll mention, finding a 20-year loan is relatively rare in this market. Interest rates are rising. Banks don't want to commit their capital for a long period of time. They're trying to make short loans so they get their money back. To find a 20-year loan, we were pleasantly surprised. Some of the feedback that we got from the bank was that in addition to your stormwater revenues, just the general financial health of the city made them feel comfortable enough to make you the loan. So they said they felt good about your overall credit. Any questions about the financing, how much we're going to borrow, the payments, the term, anything along those lines I can answer for you?
I just want to be sure you said it was fixed.
Yes, ma'am, it's fixed, fully fixed, which is even more rare. There are banks that will loan you money for 20 years, but they tell you in 10 years or 15, we're going to reset the rate on you. And this is truly fixed rate, yes, ma'am.
What was our previous rate?
I think it was a 3.16. And so it is higher. Corporate tax reform, that has pushed rates higher. You're given you're a public body, can borrow tax exempt. So if you can imagine, if corporate tax rates go down, tax exempt is less important to banks. So that means that your rates are going to be higher. And then since the beginning of this year, rates generally for borrowers like yourself are about 0.5% higher. So we are just in a higher rate environment.
We've got a 20-year period of time. The first 5 years we were penalized if we paid off early. The last 15 we're not penalized.
The first 5 years you are not allowed to prepay them. Right. And so you cannot prepay them. And then in the next 5 years, there's a 1% penalty. All of that is negotiable, and we can ask the bank to give us more favorable terms. We haven't asked the question just yet, but we can certainly do that. Yes, sir.
It may be a non-issue since we're having to pledge alcohol sale funds to even meet the payment.
You're absolutely right. There are not excess revenues in every year that you could use to prepay the debt earlier. The only way that you could, you'd have to find another revenue source. Yes, sir.
And in 11 years, we can pay it off if we had the money.
Yes, ma'am.
There'll be no penalty within 11 years.
That's right.
Any more questions?
One thing, if I may add, Madam Mayor, that alcohol sales fee, keep in mind, that is not pledged. That's not hardwired into these documents. So every year, y'all got to remember to appropriate. That's got to be part of your appropriation of that money to that fund. And once it's appropriated, it'll be taken into that fund and it'll be available.
But we always have to appropriate something.
You don't have to appropriate, that's the thing. You can decide not to appropriate. That's part of the risk the bank's taking.
That's right.
The bank knows full well that this council and successor councils will have discretion to appropriate it or not. They're counting on that you will appropriate it. But if you don't want this to go in default unless the stormwater fees go up or collections come in better.
Am I correct if it went into default then they would have the right to come in and set stormwater fees or whatever they want?
Potentially, yes, sir. They would potentially have the right to come in.
And that's their protection.
Well, you also have, and there's a covenant in here, keep in mind, that part of the security they have is in this master ordinance, as in every water and sewer master ordinance or stormwater, any sort of revenue, utility revenue ordinance. There's a covenant that says you're going to maintain rates at a level. Of course, we put in with this, along with other available funds that we'll pay for these bonds. So you have an affirmative duty that if you don't have the money to put on the rates necessary.
We have to change the rates.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If that other basket of revenues is no longer there, you have to raise rates to make up the difference to make the payment.
When we look at the cost difference, I understand bundling them into one bond, but it seems like we'd be giving up a 3.16%.
You would have to be more.
Well, the problem is that the outstanding bond holder has rights to prevent this new bond from being issued. So in order to be able to do this second piece of it, you pretty much had to take the old one out and wrap them all together into one.
And it's a good point. Even if you could do that, even if legally we were allowed to do that, the new bank wouldn't want to loan you that money because their principal repayment would come after the 15-year term of the BB&T loan. So they're not going to get their money back for 15 years. They would have a problem. They wouldn't make that loan.
Just want to note that we have $166,000 currently in the stormwater fee account, and we project by the time the first payment's due in November, it'll collect another $66,000. So it'll give us $232,000 in the account. So the first two payments could come out of the store, actual Sunday alcohol collection.
Then we wouldn't have any more money in the stormwater account to do any other stormwater projects.
Well, you got the truck, so you can have some. Any more questions? Ready to vote?
It's half a million.
Make a motion, we accept the first reading of ordinance 2006 master stormwater ordinance.
Second.
Any more discussion?
No.
Madam Mayor, I'm not opposed to things that help the city, but I couldn't vote for this first time around. I'm just not gonna be able to vote for it second time around.
Okay. All in favor of the vote, let me know, sign aye.
Speak.
Mr. McCollum?
May I be?
Oh, go ahead.
I'm the same, I'm really worried. We've now approached over 100% of our stormwater fund per year. It's grown from a $400,000 project to a $2.3 million project, to now a $2.7 million project. It's just growing and growing. And we're gonna, you know, put our city at a disadvantage from a stormwater standpoint for now 20 years. So that's very scary from a financial standpoint for my children's future.
Madam Mayor, just a question. Have we been told now by our legislative delegation, they had previously indicated they could come up with $1 million in funding to cover this shortfall? Are we now being advised that the legislative delegation is not able to come up with that money?
Well, they haven't told me, they haven't told me that they was gone?
No, I've heard nothing from them.
Councilwoman Reed, you had expressed.
If we vote now on this, or we, or let me ask this question, do we need to, do we have any opportunity to wait and see what the legislative delegation does or doesn't do before we step forward? Or do we vote now when we come back? I guess it'd be in April, and if they hadn't done anything about April, we'd have to do the second reading.
Well, you can always defer second reading. Doesn't hurt to give it a first reading, and whatever you do.
And see what's happening.
You can kick second reading down the road.
Would council be comfortable with that?
Oh, no.
Why don't y'all think that he would?
Okay, just like you may have reservations, and I have assurances. And that's where I'm going, because this is absolutely needed. We didn't get this far for it not to be. It's absolutely necessary, just like you all feel like we needed to spend a half a million on a truck to do it. This project is, this is what it's gonna cost to get it done, and it will help more than one little section of town.
Who do we have assurances from?
So now, as far as I'm saying, you have voiced yours. I am ready to vote. We are at the end, we've already started some of this project. The financing.
Point of order. Motion is on the floor. Ready to vote?
Discussion ended?
Yes.
No more discussion?
Well, you had two chances, and Mr. Middleton had two chances, and Mr. Reed had one chance. Anybody else wanna say anything that Helen spoke?
Can I ask one final question?
Go ahead.
So if we pass both these readings, we can't pay a dollar into it for the first 5 years. So even if our senator or House representative was able to get us funds, we couldn't appropriate them to this for 5 years, is that correct?
You could pay into it as much as you want, you just couldn't pay the bond off.
So as long as we don't pay it off, we won't be penalized in the first 5 years?
To put the money in the fund, absolutely, yeah. You can put all the money you want to into the appropriations fund, it can be used to pay the bond.
And can we pay some early? Can we, if we get a $500,000 grant, can we pay $500,000 into this bond?
With the current structure, if you've got $500,000 and you said to the bank, I wanna give this money back to you and no longer charge me interest on that amount, they would say that the documents state that you have to wait for the 5-year period before you can do that. So if you got it today, you'd have to wait until the 5-year term.
Partial redemption.
Partial redemption. But that's something we can negotiate with the bank. We can, in this instance, because we have the potential for a grant that's coming through, we can have them write into our documents that it is subject to no call for 5 years, except in the case where you receive grant monies, one-time payments, and banks are generally amenable to changes like that. So we can negotiate with them.
And the interest rate, is it negotiable?
No, at this point, it's not. We've taken proposals, and at the 20-year term, there aren't any other banks willing to compete for that loan.
Keep in mind, that 3% was, what was the term of the previous?
It was 15 years in a lower interest rate environment.
And 5 years less.
That's right.
5 years less.
Absolutely. It is not an unreasonable rate.
Motion is on the floor. All in favor of the vote, let me know, sign aye.
Aye.
Needs have the same right?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Thank you for coming in this morning.
So there's a second.
Okay, approval of financing for Southwest Dodge Star War project.
And that's the series ordinance.
Okay. Are you making the motion?
A motion?
Yeah.
Second.
Who made the motion?
Did you make a motion?
Oh, I didn't hear what you said.
I make a motion that we do.
Need to make a motion.
Okay. I'm making a motion that we do approve of financing for Southwest Dodge Star War project.
Second.
Okay, any discussion? It's been properly moved and seconded that we approve the financing of the Southwest Dodge Star War project. All in favor, let it be known, sign aye.
Aye.
Minutes have the same right? Motion carries. Thank you.
Thank you all.
Mr. Garland, if you would contact the legislative delegation and see what their position is.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
That's it.
Thanks.
Number five, selection Dauphin County Capital Project Sales Tax Commission. We got a letter from county. They will appoint three to the committee. Dalton will appoint one. Hart will appoint one. I think the other will be divided between Lamar and Society Hill.
The two municipal reps from Hart's on Darlington picked the one from either Lamar or Society Hill.
So we need to pick someone that know about the courthouse, know the necessity of the courthouse remaining in Darlington, not just one part, not just your part of it, but all of it. It needs to remain in the city of Darlington, not outside. And so we need to make recommendations for who we want to do that.
I thought Ronnie Ward spoke very eloquently and represented our city very well. So I would think maybe we would think about putting him under the committee.
Anybody else?
I support Ronnie Ward. I thought he did an excellent job.
Mr. Millet?
I appreciate that he volunteered to get himself on the agenda for the other night so that somebody could speak. So evidently shows that he's got a interest. Being former mayor, he's familiar with the necessity and need for these offices to remain in Darlington. So I would support him as well.
Ms. Bruce?
I'll support that.
Ms. Sheila, Ms. Beck?
I'm fine with it.
You're fine? All in favor? Somebody make a motion to nominate.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded that we nominate Mr. Ronnie Ward, the representative of the city of Darlington, for the Darlington Capital Project Sales Tax Commission. All in favor?
Aye.
Minutes have the same right? Motion carries. Thank you. That's it.
Motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
May.
Will you take me home?
You never know when a name may come.
Days are good for work.